This new section of the kitchen where I just hung the cabinets and did the backsplash was in desperate need of some more lighting. My plan is to add 4 more LED lights to this side of the kitchen, and I'm going to show you how. For this project, I am using a 6-inch hole saw and then also these 6-inch round LED ultra slim downlights. This was a 12-pack that I bought from Amazon. Each location will require this junction box along with the ultra slim light. All of your wires are connected within that junction box and then you just screw on the light. You'll also need a voltage tester along with some wire cutters. The first thing I did is mapped out where my new lights were going to go. I am going to be drawing power from this existing LED light, so I just removed that and exposed the wires. And to add new lights to my existing circuit, I'm going to be running a wire to the first light and then to the second, third, and fourth. My ceiling actually has shiplap on top of the drywall, so I'm having to use 2 different hole saws. The first hole saw is made for wood. After the wood is removed, then I switch the hole saw to the 6-inch one for drywall. And because this creates a lot of dust, I am using the shop vac to help minimize that. And I would recommend wearing eye protection as well as a mask. Now that my first hole is made, I'm going to be using this electrical push-pull kit that's basically these long rods to help guide my wire through to the existing hole. And the angle that I was at had to go through 2 trusses, so it really wasn't that easy. I called my husband and he suggested putting a bag at the end of it, and of course, that worked first try. Even though I didn't tell him that. I then taped the electrical wire to the end of that rod and just pulled it through. I untaped the rod from the new wire and just prepared the wires to be connected in the junction box. You first want to feed your wires through the holes on the side of the junction box. This way, when you're done making the connections, it will actually close. There's no need to loop the ends of your wires, just cut them and strip them about 1/2 inch. And all of your connections just get pushed right into the connectors. White into white, black into black, and the ground into green. Once all of your connections are made, you're going to close the junction box, and I just push it back up through that hole and lay it flat on the ceiling. Next, make the connection for the LED light, and there's 2 tabs on the back, so just squeeze those and then you can push it right into the ceiling. And you can make all of your hole cuts first and then run the wire, but I actually like to just do 1 at a time. And I pretty much just repeat the process by starting to cut the second hole. This time I was prepared with my eye protection and my mask. And my hole saw was not cutting as well as I would have liked it to, so I actually went and got my favorite tool, which is my multi-tool, just to help it out. And to prepare the wires for the second hole, I'm just simply cutting off how much I need for the first one. And to get the wires to the second hole, I'm just going to be using that same method as before, that electrical fish rod. And this one was a little tricky as well. Our house had an addition on it, so if you look up here in the attic, there's like the old roof and the new roof. But tying that grocery bag to the end of that rod definitely helped. So here's my first new light. I have that existing wire coming in. That's what's going to be giving me the power. And then I have my new wire that's going to be feeding to the other new lights. And I just prepared the wires to attach them to the junction box and then attach the LED light. Here's the current situation. So that was the existing light, which now gives power to that first one and now the second. And now I'm just making the third hole. And I did turn on the breaker a few times in between this just to check my connections and make sure we have light. And now I'm just going to do the same exact thing with that third and fourth light. Mess was cleaned up, here's what it looks like. 4 LED lights definitely made a difference to this area of the kitchen. And if you want more DIY tips, make sure to give me a follow. I also post DIY videos to TikTok and Instagram, so make sure to check me out at East Coast DIY. Thanks so much for watching. And if you need DIY help, make sure to send me a message on Instagram. All of the tools used in this project I bought from Amazon, so I'll make sure to link everything right in my Amazon shop for you to easily locate.